8 overpowered food sources and don't starve together. You'll never have to worry about hunger again if you watch this video till the end. Number 1 is super simple. Berries, just berries. They're super strong for restoring hunger and can be used as a great filler in the crock pot. Depending on how you play or what character you're playing as, you can choose to relocate them or just leave them around if you explore a lot. I should also mention that juicy berry bushes are better in every way compared to regular berry bushes, because you spend less time picking them, they need less fertilizer, the berries rot faster, meaning you can get more fertilizer faster, and it's easier to kill gobblers they spawn. And if you're wicker bottom, it just makes your applied horticulture book 3 times stronger in terms of food production. Number 2 is less simple, cacti. Cacti is actually an amazing food source if you have armor. It will only cost you 1 HP to pick the cacti with a football helmet. Then it can be cooked to heal 1 HP, 12.5 hunger, and 15 sanity. The sanity boost can be useful for specific bosses, such as the Bee Queen and Fuel Weaver fights. And on top of that, cactus flesh counts as a vegetable in the crock pot, so it can be used to make pierogi. And on top of all that, it regrows in winter. But wait, there's more. In summer, it also gives cactus flowers. So basically, it's just amazing. Now, number 3. Lean in. Okay, this one's super important. Smash the like button. I'm just kidding. All right, number 3 is actually ice. This is an extremely powerful food source, but only during winter and spring. Ice is gathered by mining mini glaciers and is obtained very quickly. Eating alone isn't very smart, but if you combine it with meat in the crock pot, it can become an extremely overpowered food source that makes the game way too easy. Which brings me into my next point, that combos with ice extremely well. Number 4, spider farm. Kill a level 3 den and move it nearby to your base. Then kill the spiders it spawns. They have a 50% chance to drop a monster meat, which can be used in the crock pot as a regular big meat, unless you use more than one. This basically makes any crock pot food way easier to obtain and supplements any other food source. You can also turn the monster meat into eggs by cooking it and feed it into a bird in a cage. This comes full circle to allow you to make pierogi super easily with cactus flesh, meaning health is never gonna be an issue again. Number 5, Bunny Man Farm. These are complicated. You just build a bunch of bunny hutches, I'd recommend about 20, and then feed 2 bunny men carrots during dusk or night when they're out, and force attack on one of the bunny men that are not allied to you. Do this with no weapon equipped by holding Control and F, and then quickly pressing a movement key afterwards so the punch doesn't connect. Then your allied bunny men will attack them, which causes the other bunny men to help defend the one that got attacked, but then your allied ones get hit by other bunny men, which causes more bunny men to come help them, creating an all-out bunny man war. Sit in the middle of this, hold spacebar to take the loot, but don't pick up meat. Do not pick up meat that they drop. They will kill you. Just don't do that. Number 5-4. This one's combination of tip number 5 and 4, so that's why I call it that. Bunnymen can also be used to make spider farms automatic. Place 9 bunny hutches next to the spider den, and they'll take care of all the spiders. In the morning, pick up the loot. The spiders will even kill the bunnymen sometimes, so there can be big meat waiting for you, or carrots. Now, everything after this is going to be a little bit harder to obtain, but they're like super overpowered food sources that will make life super easy. So, number 6, Lichen Farm. The strongest food source in the game is lichen. It only spawns in the ruins in the first biome, the wilds, and has one of the fastest spoil times in the game, being 2 days. Besides its rot time and sanity reduction of 5, it is exactly the same as a roasted carrot without even having to cook it. So, on top of that, here's why it becomes OP. It's extremely easy to gather. There's tons of it. It's all over the place in the ruins. And Wickerbottom can bring it back with applied horticulture, and lure plants can pick it for you. So here's what you do. You first gonna need to kill the Bee Queen. You have to have bundling wraps for this, or else this isn't going to work out very well for you. Then you're going to need a lure plant and be playing Wickerbottom, or have someone in your game playing Wickerbottom. And then you farm it by placing the lure plant in the middle of a large cluster of lichen, leaving it until it grows so there's the eye plants around it, and then you come back and spam the book Applied Horticulture however many times you like, And note that it isn't actually however many times you like. There is an upper limit. You can't let it hold on to more than 600 lichen. It just can't do that. So stop before then. After that, kill it. Pick up the stacks of lichen and wrap them in bundling wraps. Then, when you have a huge stockpile of monster meat and eggs, turn them all into pierogi, and then you can rewrap them for later. Note that you cannot automatically farm lichen in winter, due to the lure plant not being able to grow, but you can still manually pick the lichen. So lichen grows in winter, so it's still a strong food source then. Number 7, honey. Specifically with a winter honey farm, the best food source in the game if you have no wicker bottom. Place 40 bee boxes evenly with flowers nearby in an area that you never visit. Then come and harvest them in winter only once a year. This will cover half of your yearly hunger needs if you eat the honey raw even. While cooking it into good crockpot dishes with meat you find throughout the year, it'll be enough to sustain you forever, and you only have to farm that honey once every year. Number 8, Spelunky Farm. Once again, worker bottom only for the strong variant. While in Spelunkies, fill the rest of the area around the area with hay walls and break them down. Stand next to the Spelunky pens and use the book On Tentacles. This will spawn tentacles in the pens, and you can do this as much as you want. And if you do it enough, the tentacles will never die. That's what I'd recommend doing. Then enter the pen with the Lazy Forager equipped, and don't stop running. Whatever you do, don't stop running in there. And then that will give you tons of nightmare fuel, bananas, and morsels. Now that's all for today, guys. If you liked the video, feel free to hit the subscribe button, and then hit the notification bell so that you always get notifications. Thanks, guys.